Hello, Vital Sign. Today I'd like to talk about clique polynomials, including four important properties and two equations involving them. The clique polynomial of an undirected simple graph is defined as a polynomial in X whose coefficient on an n-degree term is the number of n-cliques in that graph. In other words, it is the sum from k equals 0 to m, where m is the size of the largest clique in the graph, of a sub k times x to the k power, where a sub k is the number of k-cliques in that graph. The shorthand notation for the clique polynomial of some graph G is this, which means the clique polynomial of G evaluated at x. Here are a few examples of clique polynomials. The largest clique in this graph is a 3-clique, meaning m is 3, so we'll be summing from k equals 0 to 3. This graph has one 0-clique, corresponding to the empty set of vertices in the graph, so a sub 0 is 1. It has three 1-cliques, each corresponding to a single vertex in the graph, so a sub 1 is 3. It also has three 2-cliques, each corresponding to an edge, or pair of two mutually connected vertices in the graph. A sub 2, then, is 3. It has one 3-clique, so a sub 3 is 1. The clique polynomial of this graph, then, is 1 plus 3x plus 3x squared plus x cubed. The largest clique in this graph is a 2-clique, as there are no 3-cliques, so m is 2 in this case. This graph has one 0-clique, 4 1-cliques, and two 2-cliques. So a sub 0 is 1, a sub 1 is 4, and a sub 2 is 2. Therefore, the clique polynomial of this graph is 1 plus 4x plus 2x squared. See how the coefficients count the number of cliques of a given size in a graph? Now for one final example. The largest clique in this graph is a 2-clique, meaning that m is 2. The graph has one 0-clique, 4 1-cliques, and two 2-cliques. Its clique polynomial, then, is 1 plus 4x plus 2x squared. Hang on, wasn't that the clique polynomial of the previous graph? Yes, it was, and this shows us that two non-isomorphic graphs can have the same clique polynomial. Let's look at some major properties of clique polynomials. The first property is that for any clique polynomial, the constant term is always 1, as every graph has exactly one 0-clique corresponding to the empty subgraph. This also implies that the clique polynomial of any graph evaluated at 0 is 1. The second property is that if a clique polynomial is of degree m, meaning its highest power term is some constant times x to the m power, then the coefficients on all lower degree terms must be non-zero. That is, a sub 0 through a sub m minus 1 are all non-zero. This follows from the fact that if there are any m cliques in the graph, there must be cliques of all sizes lower than m as well. For example, suppose we have some graph G whose largest clique is a 4-clique, meaning that the graph shown here is a subgraph of G. Then within this 4-clique subgraph, we can find 3-cliques, 2-cliques, 1-cliques, and the 0-clique, meaning that G contains 3, 2, 1, and 0-cliques also. Further, this implies that if the highest degree term in the clique polynomial is m, then the coefficients on all lower degree terms must be at least m choose k for k less than m, as that is the number of k-cliques in the complete subgraph on m vertices that we know must be a part of our graph. The third property is, since all of the coefficients are positive, as they are counting the actual numbers of cliques in a graph, and the clique polynomial is 1 when x equals 0, the only possible real roots to clique polynomials are negative real roots. There can be no positive real roots. The fourth property relates to graph operations. If we took the disjoint union of two graphs, G and H, the resulting graph has clique polynomial equal to the sum of the clique polynomials of G and H, minus 1. This is because every non-zero clique in G and every non-zero clique in H is in the disjoint union of G and H, but no new cliques are formed by the disjoint union. Also, the zero clique would have been counted twice if we just added the clique polynomials, so we had to subtract a constant 1. Now let's cover two important equations involving clique polynomials. In order to understand these equations, we'll need some new notation, first for subgraphs. Suppose we have some graph G. A spanning subgraph of G is some subgraph of G that contains all of the vertices in G, but does not necessarily contain all of the edges. That is, to form a spanning subgraph, we remove some edges from our graph, but we do not remove any vertices. On the right, you can see a spanning subgraph of G, which is just the original graph minus an edge AB. Note that we express this subgraph as G minus AB. This graph is not a spanning subgraph because it is missing vertex D. Now to review induced subgraphs. Formally, if a graph G has a vertex set V and edge set E, an induced subgraph is a graph whose vertex set is a subset S of V, and whose edge set is the set of all edges in E that have both endpoints in S. Induced subgraphs are found by choosing some subset of our graph's set of vertices. For example, A, B, and C in this case, and then deleting every edge that is not between two vertices in that subset, and then deleting every vertex not in that subset. What we have in this case is the subgraph of G induced by the set of vertices A, B, and C. This process of choosing a subset of our graph's vertex set is what we mean by inducing the subgraph. Note that this would not be an induced subgraph, because there's an edge missing between two of our chosen vertices, B and C, that was present in the original graph. Essentially, with induced subgraphs, you have no freedom over which edges you keep once you've chosen your vertices. Note how we express induced subgraphs. G bracket S means the subgraph induced by vertex set S on G, where S is some subset of the vertices of G. If an induced subgraph contains every vertex except for one, we could denote it like this, with a slash before the vertex that we are excluding from our subgraph. The last bit of notation we need is that of a neighborhood. The neighborhood of a vertex, V, is simply the set of vertices adjacent to V. In this example, the neighborhood of vertex A is B and D. We are now ready to examine two powerful equations involving clique polynomials. The first is this. What this means is that the clique polynomial of a graph G evaluated at X equals the clique polynomial evaluated at X of the subgraph induced by every vertex except for an arbitrary vertex V plus X times the clique polynomial evaluated at X of the subgraph induced by the neighborhood of our arbitrary vertex V. This equality holds for all x and for any vertex v in any graph G. Here's an example. In this example, our arbitrary vertex v is vertex A. As you can see, the clique polynomial of the entire graph G is equal to the clique polynomial of the subgraph induced by vertices B and C, that is the graph G without A, plus x times the clique polynomial of the subgraph induced by the neighborhood of A. The reasoning behind this expression is that any n-clique in G either contains our arbitrary vertex V or not. All of the n-cliques that do not contain our vertex V are included in the coefficient of the nth degree term of the clique polynomial for the induced subgraph of G without V. All of the n-cliques that do contain vertex V necessarily correspond to a set of n-1 mutually adjacent vertices in the neighborhood of V. That is, every n-clique in G that contains vertex V corresponds to an n-1 clique in the subgraph induced by the neighborhood of E. So by adding the coefficient of the n minus 1 degree term in the neighborhood-induced subgraph polynomial to the nth degree term in the other subgraph's polynomial, we would get the coefficient of the nth degree term of the original graph's Clique polynomial. The way we actually implement this addition of coefficients on n and n minus 1 degree terms is simply shifting the Clique polynomial of the neighborhood-induced subgraph upwards by 1 degree for each term, accomplished by a multiplication by x. Here's a concrete example of this equality. Let's suppose our arbitrary vertex is b. Then here's the graph g without b, and its Clique polynomial. And here is the graph induced by the neighborhood of b, and its Clique polynomial. Now let's multiply the Clique polynomial of the neighborhood-induced subgraph by x to shift its degrees up by 1. Now add that to the Clique polynomial of g without b, and what you get is the Clique polynomial of the entire graph. This is all because n-cliques that involved vertex b were counted in this Clique polynomial's n minus 1 degree coefficient, and n-cliques that did not contain vertex b were counted in this Clique polynomial's n degree coefficient. Now let's take a look at the second important equation for Clique polynomials. Here it is. Okay, this one looks a little bit more complicated, but the idea behind it is actually very similar to that of the previous expression. This expression means that the Clique polynomial of a graph G evaluated at x equals the Clique polynomial evaluated at x of a spanning subgraph of G formed by excluding just a single arbitrary edge uv, in this example, perhaps edge ac, plus x squared times the Clique polynomial evaluated at x of the subgraph induced by the intersection of the neighborhoods of the endpoints of our arbitrary edge uv. In this case, that would be by the intersection of the neighborhoods of A and C. The reasoning behind this expression is that if our graph G has an n-clique, it either contains the arbitrary edge uv or it does not. All of the n-cliques that do not contain the edge uv are counted in the coefficient of the nth degree term in the Clique polynomial for G minus edge uv, while all of the n-cliques that do contain the edge uv correspond to an n minus 2 clique in the subgraph induced by the intersection of the neighborhoods of our arbitrary edge uv. That means that all of the n-cliques containing edge uv are counted in the coefficient of the n minus 2 degree term in the Clique polynomial for the subgraph in the right term of the expression. In order for us to be able to add the coefficient on the n minus 2 degree term in the neighborhood-induced subgraph's Clique polynomial to the coefficient on the n degree term in the spanning subgraph's Clique polynomial, we have to shift the position of the coefficients of the neighborhood-induced subgraph polynomial by 2 using a multiplication by x squared. Here's a concrete example of this equation. The Clique polynomial of graph G is this. Now let's obtain our spanning subgraph by removing a single edge, say edge AB. This is the Clique polynomial of our spanning subgraph. Next, let's find the subgraph induced by the intersection of the neighborhoods of A and B. There we go. And its Clique polynomial is this. Now multiply that Clique polynomial by x squared and add it to the one for g minus ab. Sure enough, the result is equal to our original Clique polynomial. You may be wondering, why are these two expressions important? Well, they allow us to prove two powerful theorems, which in turn allow us to define new, necessary conditions for graphs to contain Hamiltonian cycles. They also allow us to prove Taran's theorem for triangle-free graphs, which states that the maximum number of edges in a triangle-free graph on n vertices is the floor of n squared over 4. In a future video, I'll cover these two important Clique polynomial theorems. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment if you liked the video. Have a great day.